Okay. I wanted to make sure it was coming on. I've always learned to smile at the beginning and just wait. So, hey, so we're here Friday night. Welcome to the She Shed again. I decided I kind of like videoing in here. It's one, quiet. Two, quiet. Three, did I say it was quiet? It's like super quiet in here, so I like it. Well, you hear my clocks ticking. I have like two clocks, one in front of me and one behind me. So you hear the one that's in front of me, and it's ticking. So if you hear it, that's what it is. So, yeah, it's Friday, and I got nothing, guys. Nothing. Today has just been a week. Hey, Mom. Love you. Miss ya. It has been a crazy week, and it's just, I don't even know how to explain it. I thought it was just me, and I even made a comment to a lady at work. I said, you know, I'm just glad this week is done. It's just been crazy, and she's like, yeah, it's been like that for me, and apparently it is just, I guess because today is Friday the 13th, who knows. But I'm glad it's done. I'm glad work is done for the week, and I can just decorate for Christmas this weekend. I decided, I think I'm going to try changing the topic. Again, you should know that by now with me. I've changed topic on you several times throughout the whole conversation. So I think I'm going to make Friday nights my live feed night. Usually that's just a night that me and my family, we calm down from the week and just chill and don't do much of anything. And I just kind of like coming out here. I'm starting to kind of like come out here and just chill. And I've actually been thinking about starting on this thing. I was supposed to have it ready for Halloween. Try to get into view. I don't know if it's even, she even coming through. She was supposed to be done for Halloween, but I never got back out here to finish her. As you can see that she's just has black hair and that's it. You should ask Mom about my projects. She can vouch. I take forever doing projects. How long did it take me to make that snowman wreath for you, Mom? About 2 years, I think. Or was it a year? I don't know. Something like that. So, yeah. Not much has been going on. Like I said, it's been crazy but quiet. Yeah, I don't know. I really don't know, guys. So, I really don't know what to talk to you about. Mom said, yep. She knows. Yeah, I don't know. I don't like it. My camera is like this way, but when I look at my screen, it's this way, and it's, I don't know. I should move it because then I can kind of see myself better on the screen, but it don't really matter. I don't think, does it? I don't know. Tells you I don't got much going on. Funny story about me. I have a fear of birds. I don't like birds. And our next door neighbors. My face looks white. Is it flushed? Is this light too much? Who knows? Anyway, our neighbors have chickens. And when they go out of town, my son's supposed to take care of these chickens. And basically, he just goes out in the morning, lets them out. And then at night, he goes and feeds them and puts them back in the cage, back in the coop. Well, chickens are still birds to me. I don't care. They're birds, okay? I don't like birds, period. So, one Saturday, my husband and son left to go somewhere. They forgot to let out the birds, or let out the chickens. And my mom and I were getting ready to go out, and I told my mom, I said, hey, I gotta go let these chickens out, because they forgot. So, we go outside and she stands on my back deck while I go across the yard and into my neighbor's yard to let these chickens out. Now, mind you, I'm already not liking birds, and I'm scared of them. And these chickens, I know they could peck you to death. Well, not to death, but to me they can. And my husband and son both told me, don't worry, they stay at the back of the coop. They will not come near the door. They're more scared of you than you are of them. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. They'll be fine. Just let them out. Okay. So I go over there. The chickens are near the door. I'm trying to get this door to open, and they're blocking the door because they're right at the door. I finally get the door open. Those chickens come running out at me. I'm walking away quickly as I can. My mom starts laughing. She's yelling at me, "They're right behind you! They're right behind you!" I turn around. These birds are starting to flap their wings at me. They're chasing me. You want to see a fat chick run? Watch this fat chick run. My mom did nothing but laugh at me the whole entire time while these birds are chasing me. Okay, chickens are chasing me across the yard. I was like, never again. Not happening. This morning, my son forgot to let out the chickens. Our neighbors wanted him to take care of the chickens today and for the next few days. He forgot to let the chickens out. So, guess who had to let the chickens out today? Yeah, that was me. So, I head over there to let these chickens out. Now, a little bit of another story before I get to that story. So, before our neighbors got the chickens, we told them, we were talking about our dog. And we're like, he won't bother the chickens unless they come in our yard. If they end up in our yard, in his mind, it's like it's free game, basically. And about 2 months ago, we found a dead chicken in our yard. Our dog had got a hold of the chicken, okay? And so, anyway, we disciplined him, told him no, and so he knows that he's not to mess with the chickens anymore. So on my way over there to meet the chickens to let them out, my dog goes running with me because he's like, oh yeah, she's going to the chickens, and he wants to go in the yard with me, which I told him no. I told him stay. So I closed the gate behind me. He looks at me like, come on, let me in, let me in. His tail's all wagging, he's all happy. I'm like, dude, I'm not trusting you with around these chickens, not in this yard. So anyway, I get to the coop. They're near the door. I'm like, dang it. I'm like, get back, get back, get back, go back to the coop. Get to back to the coop. They don't listen. They're chickens. Whatever. So I go to open up the gate. Of course, they all come piling out of the gate. As I'm trying to hurry up and walk across this yard, because they moved the coop to where it's further in the middle of the yard, so now it takes me longer to get out of the yard away from the chickens. I'm going, you're stronger than a chicken. You're stronger than a chicken. Don't let the chicken scare you. Don't let the chicken scare you. You're stronger than a chicken. And I'm telling myself this. As I look down, there's a stupid chicken right beside me, and I'm going, oh my God. So I'm trying to hurry up the pace, pick up the pace. Chicken's picking up the pace. My dog's on the other side of the gate looking at me, wagging his tail. He's getting all excited because that chicken's getting closer. Well, I think that chicken might have watched the death of his brother or sister, whatever one it is, because as soon as he saw my dog, he hightailed the other direction. It's like the poor chicken was traumatized by the dog. He's kind of like, dog! And just ran. It was quite funny. But wasn't as funny as the first experience that I had, where the chickens were actually flapping their wings and flying at me because their wings were not clipped at that point. But they're clipped now, so I don't have to worry about chickens. But yeah, I don't date birds, people. My family can probably tell you so many stories of me and birds. Even my son, a bird flew into our garage, and we were getting ready to leave one morning, and my son yells, "There's a bird in the garage!" And I had just opened the door, and he saw it flew by the door. I slammed that door shut, ran all the way back to my bedroom and hid. My bedroom's all completely on the other side of the house from the garage doors. I guess I thought that chicken bird was gonna fly around me. Meanwhile, I left my son standing at the door. Yeah, at least I'm not one of those parents that just knocked their kid over, though. I didn't knock him over. I just ran away because of a bird. So. That's my chicken story. So at dinner, I told the guys, I said, I'm not tending to the chickens anymore. I am not going out there. That is your all's problem, not mine. Not happening. So, okay, my mom said talk about weather, COVID, politics, or Christmas. You want to hear a funny story about COVID, Mom? So, they're at work about last week. Of course, last week I had the 10 million, it felt like 10 million appointments going on. My coworker was supposed to go, into this meeting last Friday, a week from now, or a week ago. And she didn't want to do it. She was trying to talk me into going, and I said, no, not happening. I've got too many appointments. I got that doctor that I told you that was looking at my back and stuff. And I said, I can't. I'm not doing this. And they're going to be doing this meeting for a while anyway. And I'm like, I don't have time for this. She got an email. So she ended up having to go still because they wouldn't let her swap out to begin with, which worked out. She got an email on Tuesday stating that somebody in that meeting had COVID, has tested positive for COVID. So by this time, I've already been around her and I'm like, crap, okay. Honestly, I think I'm fine. This girl that caught it was on the other side of the room. And, I don't know what's going to happen there. And then word has it that another person in our corporate office has COVID. So, Sandy's just masking up and germexing a lot more than what I was already doing. So everything's going to be fine. I'm not worried about it. It'll be all right. But yeah, fun times with COVID. My son's getting tired of wearing his mask already at school. They have to wear it all day. And this was the first week for 5 days a week of school. So he's done with that. He's like, I'm over this mask. Don't blame him. I'm up there with him too, but we gotta do what we gotta do. Something else happened. Oh, I know what it was. So sometimes I could be a little bit of a smart butt. And this guy, one of my things is if you're going to throw me under the bus, make sure you have your facts in order. Because, make sure you have your facts in order because I'll prove you wrong if I can. And a lot of times I can. And so he was telling my boss that we still had an open order from October that I haven't filled yet. It means I haven't purchased the item and it was toilet paper. Well, it turns out I did. It turns out that the receiving people never received it in. And so therefore, I did my job. So he ran his mouth for nothing. So me being me, I'm like, you need toilet paper? Okay, let me buy you some toilet paper. I doubled his order today. He's going to have a double shipment of toilet paper arrive on Monday. Make me mad. And I'll double your order of toilet paper. And guess what, buddy? It goes towards your expense account, not mine. And it goes on your budget, not mine. Your P&L, not mine. So, hey. Yeah. So, he's going to get a double shipment of toilet paper. I hope he enjoys that toilet paper. I wish I could be back there when they received that toilet paper in. I ordered 50 cases.
There's Johnny.
He said, here's Johnny.
I told you I was coming.
Yeah, I saw it. Hey, guess what happened when I came in the shop?
What?
Today's been my day with creatures. Oh, thank you. Mm-hmm. There was a lizard on the door. I opened it up and he jumped at me and I screamed. I was waiting for you and Dad to come running because I screamed. So then he got on the door frame and then I swatted him off of the door frame and threw him across the yard.
Why?
He probably died.
The poor... What?
he wouldn't have died. He landed on all fours. He's like a cat.
How'd you all tell? Fours. It was all dark outside.
Well, the light. Remember the light above my shop?
Better tell Sally.
Hmm?
Go tell Sally.
Sally the salamander. She...
What?
They found a salamander in the yard. They kept it.
It's not any ordinary salamander.
Huh?
It's not any ordinary.
Yeah.
So you just doing a little talk?
No, I haven't done any TikToks. Oh, yeah, I'm into TikTok now, people.
Ew, don't watch it.
I embarrassed him with one of the videos I posted.
No, it's literally weird. Hold on, give me a second.
Come on.
What?
You gotta admit, it was a good video.
Don't tell me at night.
Huh?
Don't tell me.
I showed him right before you went to bed. He's like, great, now I'm gonna have nightmares all night.
Wait, so what is this, Sandy or Rose Petals?
Hmm?
What is it, Sandy or Rose Petals? What was it?
Neither. It's S. Martinez 20. S. Dot Martinez 20.
Plug.
Plug.
Is it M-A-R-I or M-I-R-T?
M-A-R. M-A-R-T-I-N-E-Z.
Damn, I spelled my name, last name wrong.
And how long have you been spelling your last name now?
I don't know.
We have the same last name. Just saying.
Is it Martinez 2020?
Mm-hmm. I thought you were following me anyway.
I don't know how to look at my phone or who I'm following. Oh, I found you. Don't look at me like that. 400 views.
Oh, I got 400 views, people.
Alright, so there's the camera. Watch that camera. Yeah. That's my man. Oh, my hip. Oh.
I don't know. Hips do lie.
This is my favorite one. Where's the camera? That's her real makeup. Drink a coffee,
Lime life?
Shebang. Stupid lying.
I know, but you can still see it, I think.
I think so.
Yeah.
Look at your desk.
Actually, you did that to my desk. But you were like, I think 3 or 4 when you did that. So. I didn't realize until after I watched the other video that he was doing that to me while I was talking, and I had no idea. But yeah. I think we lost Grandma. Grandma was on here, but now she's gone, I think.
Yeah, so just a Mandalorian.
Y'all already finished that?
Mm-hmm, it was only 34 minutes, so this one. So we doing all your lashes, talking?
Yeah, because I got nothing. I'm bored. Yeah. I was going to start painting this thing again, but... Well, I got the black done. I don't know what I'm going to do. I might just sit here and just stare at the camera. Told you. You never know what you're going to get with us.
Can I pick this one?
Well, that's what you were originally going to do. But we're not going to do it tonight because we're not going to be out here for very long.
Oh, I'm sorry. I want
to pick that. Yeah, that was you... Yeah, you originally were supposed to paint that anyway. So.
I want to show them how I wear my pants, but...
Y'all don't want to see that.
I'll just have you know my pajamas are right here. Right here. They're right here. See, it keeps going.
Yeah.
I was just stressed them out, but...
Oh, so I did post on my website, on my website, on Rose Petals, at Lime Life, some pictures of, well, I just did one of them tonight, the holiday lollipop little collection, $38. See if I can get over there and see what, it's $38 and you have, I just don't like to make sure I tell the right information. I don't want to be wrong, but you have, where is that post? Don't do that, dude. Where did my post go? I did not go on that one. Oh, gosh. I bet you it went to my other page.
What?
Because I'm kind of stupid like that sometimes. I don't pay attention to what page it went on, and I put it on the wrong page. No. Didn't go to that one either. Great, it's lost in no man's land. Sorry, guys.
Is it this one?
Yeah. Why is it not showing up on my computer?
I had to scroll kind of far.
Okay, sorry. So the Lime Life Lollipop Little Collection comes with, for $38, it comes with the Travel Size Perfect Lip Gloss, Enduring Lip Color, Enduring Eyeliner Pencil, and Perfect Mascara. Yeah, pretty neat. I mean, $38, that's...
$38? Sheesh! So you're saying you'd rather pay $30 in makeup than $30 in Champion sweatshirt?
I'm just ignoring him right now.
$30 for a makeup, that's expensive. Don't you get it for free because you work there? Is that what reason you work there?
No, I don't get it for free.
Half off?
No.
Full price?
No. Anyway.
Doesn't
make sense. So it's a great little collection to get started. Great Christmas gift for teens. And, I still got my enduring eyeliner on. If you can see it, the light is like extremely not working for me tonight. I haven't tried enduring lip pencil yet. I've been hesitant to do it. I'm so afraid to do it. And then it's going to, I'm always, stop. I'm going to have that permanent lip line around my lips and the lipsticks are going to be gone. And you'll just see this line. That's why I haven't worn it. I haven't tried it. Maybe I'll try it tomorrow. That way I'm home and nobody will see it but my family. So, stop making so much noise, please. And stop playing around my drawers. Yeah. But anyway. So that's it. That's all that's going on. Not too exciting. You what?
I'm trying to get care about. It's weird because it's like...
Yeah, your reverse kind of thing.
Before, it won't go in. I get back and...
Yeah, it's... Say, I can't. It's like reverse.
Why?
Because I'm using that camera instead of my laptop, so it kind of reverses it all. Mm-hmm. So.
Yeah.
Sorry guys, we're just not too entertaining tonight. Like I said, I'm tired. It's been a week. It's
He did nothing.
Don't forget, I'm looking at the Lime Life book. We also have stuff for guys.
You do? So,
yeah. I see that. I've already told you and Dad both that we had stuff for guys. So we have stuff for guys. Shaving cream, shampoo, body wash, or not shampoo, face and body wash.
Do you have a body wash?
And moisturizer. So, and you can also get the collection in the Tin Man Holiday Collection.
What the
heck?
Wait, does the soap for babies come with the stuffed animal?
Yeah.
Can we order the bunny one?
For what?
So I can get this to family.
No.
But he's so cute.
No.
How do babies get all the attention? Oh, tell them about Pizza Inn. So at Pizza, we went to Pizza Inn tonight. And if you are 10 and under, you get half off or something.
Yeah, you get a discount. Well, price.
I'm 11 now. We still tell him I'm 10. So I'm gonna be 22 years old going there. Oh, he's 10. Yeah, man, I'm 10. I'm like 6'2". Yeah, I'm 10.
So another funny story that happened at Pizza Inn that I forgot about. So I'm highly allergic.
I'm so sorry.
To pineapple. And allergic as in the aspect of I will stop breathing. It swells up my tongue, my lips, my throat. And yeah, so I can't breathe. And so my husband had gotten a dessert that had pineapple in it. And I'm looking at it, it's like, dude, really? You know, and of course the bad part is for me, I cannot eat anything that's around that pineapple area on the bar. Because somebody can drip juices on it, or the food can touch, or even in this situation, because of the spatulas that they use to scoop it up. If you use the same, like for him, he had grabbed two different kinds of desserts. So if he used a spatula for the pineapple, and then reached over and used it to grab another dessert, that juice could have went on that dessert, and I could still get it. It could still cause me to have a reaction. So I cannot eat anything around that. So anyway, so as he's eating it, I'm kind of like, really? You're eating that, really? He's like, yeah. He goes, imagine if we were on a deserted island, and it was just you and I, and pineapple was all you're going to eat. I said, well, all you can eat. I said, well, no matter what, I'm going to die then. I said, either pineapple's going to kill me or I'm going to die from starvation. And he's like, hey, guess when you start looking at me like you're going to eat me because you have no other choice, I'll just cover myself in pineapple juice. I'm like, that's messed up. Why are you going to do that to me? He said, I'll wake up in the middle of the night and you're going to be like having a hard time breathing. I'm like, you had to lick me, didn't you? So yeah, pineapple juice is a serious thing for me, along with all the other crap I'm allergic to.
Wait, allergic to crap?
Yep.
Done.
But yeah, pineapple. Who would have thunk it? Also, I'm allergic to ginger, but ginger is not as bad as pineapple. Pineapple is immediate reaction.
I'm going to sign out.
See ya.
I had to go use the bathroom. Probably the only viewer in your life.
He always makes some kind of bathroom comment when he comes here. All right.
Pee on the side of your shop here.
No. So anyway, yeah.
Wild in the dark.
What? Oh.
Wild in the dark.
Bye. Bye.
What if I just plug up my flashlight and it scares the crap out of me?
That kid. And he's really doing that. He's going outside to go to the bathroom. Joys of a boy. What was I talking about? Oh, pineapple and ginger. So yeah, there's an interesting fact for you. Pineapple and ginger. I don't know why. I'm just allergic to them. And almonds. I can't eat almonds. Well, I'm not so much allergic to almonds. My body doesn't like almonds. It makes me really sick to my stomach. Like where I'm in pain, sick. So, I think you need to know that, but hey. At least if I need toilet paper, there'll be a bunch of toilet paper at work. For my double shipment. Oh my gosh. I'm sorry, people. I thought I'd do better tonight, but I've got nothing going on. So, like I said, Lime Life, we have a lot of great deals going on, a lot of great stuff going on for the holiday collection. I'm really excited about Monday's launch. I think it's coming up Monday. I'm not not sure if I'm allowed to talk about that or not. I'll hold off on that because I don't know. I don't want to get in trouble for that. Just know I like Mondays. I think Mondays is really cute, so. And I'm still thinking about Wizard of Oz, people. And the more I mess with this eyeliner, so I tried to use my own eyeliner the other day, and I just didn't like it. I had to get the Enduring back on. I like the Enduring eyeliner. And that's what Wizard of Oz is. It's in different colors. 10 colors for $80. It's actually 5 pencils, 2 colors on each pencil. And yeah, I don't know. I'm really thinking about it. Oh, samples. So I think I told you, did I tell you guys that last week? No, I haven't talked to you guys since last Friday. My son says, I see you, look behind you. Yeah, whatever, he's not there. So I ordered samples for Bamboo Renew, Skin Therapy, Quench Cleanse, and 40 Cure Cream. Okay. I got the samples in and I ordered. You get 30 packs per skincare. Okay. I read one quantity of 30 packs. I literally received one pack of each item. I didn't get the other 29 packs of each item. So anyway, I called Lime Life and they immediately fixed it with no problems at all. So they're in the mail. They're going to be here sometime. I think when I last looked, they're going to be here Tuesday. Excuse me. I had an allergy shot yesterday, last night, and I do this for about 24 hours. I get choked up and congestion. Anyway, so I will have the sample packs hopefully Tuesday or Wednesday is what I'm shooting for. And so, like I said, it's Bamboo Renew, which is the body scrub, Quench Cleanse, which is a facial wash, Skin Therapy, which is a moisturizer, but also it helps with, like, if you have imperfections in your cheek, it will. It evens out your skin tone is what I'm trying to say. And plus, it'll also help tighten up the skin some. And then you have 40 Cure Cream. And that's a moisturizer lotion, body lotion. So those are the things I use right now. And that's one of the reasons why I bought samples, because I can really vouch for those items right now. And plus, I don't think they have, I think they have other ones, but I don't use those yet. So I wasn't really wanting to get samples on those. So my samples are supposed to be here. Like I said, they're supposed to be here hopefully Tuesday or Wednesday. So if any of you guys want to try a sample or want some samples, I can send you some so you can try them out. Because, like I said, I love them. I won't be able to say this enough times. I mean, I'll say it every time to you guys that the Bamboo Renew is great for the keratosis pilaris, psoriasis. It's a body scrub. It's great. Sorry, my seat's uncomfortable to me tonight, and so I'm fidgeting a lot. 40 Cure Cream's the same thing. It's great for the keratosis. It's great for psoriasis, eczema, however you want to say that word. Dry feet. If you have the the callus is really bad on your feet. It's supposed to be good for that. One thing, I don't know if you can see this or not, but I have, I call it the finance elbow. Because whenever I work, I lean on that elbow. And you'll see a lot of people in finance have dark elbows right here from where we're always leaning on them. And basically, it's just really dry skin. I started using the 40 Cure Cream on that, and it's actually gone away a good bit. So I'm really happy with that. But actually, I used the Bamboo Renew on it, and then I finished it with the 40 Cure Cream. The Quench Cleanse and the Skin Therapy I use at night, which I did my facial night routine the other night. I did talk to you guys not too long ago. But anyway, it has really evened out my skin tone a lot between those two. I still get some acne, but I can deal with that versus to what I used to have. It was really bad. So, yeah, it's really dry out here. I'm getting choked up. So I'm probably going to be in this soon. So those things are great. I wish I knew about Lyme life along a lot sooner. Because I have gotten my confidence back where I don't mind going without my makeup. Which for whatever reason, I just remembered I didn't even text my best friend back. She texted me this morning and I forgot to text back. So if you're watching, I'm sorry. I'll get back with you soon. I'm a horrible friend, people. I really am. I'm not very good on returning text messages. I'm not very good on answering phone calls. I don't like being on the phone. So you have better chance of texting me than you are to call me. A lot of my times my phone's on mute. So if it rings, I never hear it. I'm one of those people. So yeah. I wish I would have known my life years ago. Years. Because my skin has always been an issue for me. And I was embarrassed. Straight out. My arms were really bad. I would not wear bell sleeves or tank tops. I would always wear quarter sleeves or long t-shirt sleeves. And I say long t-shirts, no, it's like they would literally have to come like right to here. Like with this one's up here, it would have to come down to here. I hated being in my bathing suit because people would see my arms. And I finally got my arms figured out a couple years ago, where it was a lot easier for me. And I was using a lye soap. And now, you know, I use the Bamboo Renew on it, and that's doing really well. So, face-wise, I hated going anywhere without my makeup on. I wore makeup pretty much 7 days a week. And if we were going to be home, I didn't wear it. But if I knew we were going to go out, I had to have time to put makeup on. You would not catch me without my makeup. While we were in Reno visiting family in September, was the first time they asked, some of them actually saw me without makeup. Because even at that point, I wasn't even with Lyme Life yet. But it was just so hot. And wearing mask, I was just like, I can't do this makeup at the same time. But now, I think I go out more now without makeup than what I have ever in my life. Shoot, I went to work 2 weeks ago. Remember when I had pink eye? I went to work with no makeup on. And that was the first time I felt confident enough, comfortable enough to go without it. Because Lyme Life has started even out my skin tone so much that and took away the rosacea. I don't want to say take it away, but I mean, it really, really dialed it down. And I was able to go without it. And that was a big factor for me. It was a big deal. And it was funny because I had a couple of people tell me, what's wrong with you? And my immediate reaction is, well, I don't have no makeup on. They're like, no, we're talking about your eyes. It's like, oh, because I was so paranoid over my face, my skin complexion, that when they ask me what's wrong with me, I immediately think they're talking about my face, and they're asking about my red eye that I have that's all glassy and funky looking. Oh, okay, So it was a nice difference, It was good. So anyway, so it's definitely worth trying. And I'm a fan of, I'm not gonna push something that I don't know much about. In other words, like we have this one product called Due Date. I can't use it because it smells like sandalwood, which I told you about that before. I can't tell you much about it. I can tell you, hey, we have this product. This is what it can do, or what it's supposed to do. But I can't sit here and tell you, go buy it, go buy it, go buy it. I'll encourage you to buy stuff that I know that works for me. And then the makeup stuff is just a plus. Because the makeup, like I said, I'll repeat it over and over again. I use other cosmetics. I will not always be 100% LimeLife. And I don't think any girl does. I mean, honestly, I don't think there's one girl out there just that sticks to one brand of cosmetics and don't have anything else mixed into that batch. There are a couple of things I use that LimeLife does not make. And I'm not going to give those up because they work. Like one for me is an eye primer. It's not a setting spray, an eye primer. Because you can see how my eyelids tuck in and my eyeshadow will crease right there in the middle. And my eyeshadow comes off. And a couple hours in, you'll find my eyeshadow right into the crease of my eye. So when I look down, you just see this line of eyeshadow. And so this eye primer I use was a lifesaver. For years, I stopped wearing eyeshadow because I got tired of it just disappearing. And I'm like, what's the point? I'm not gonna wear it. And then I came across it one day. I got a sample of it and tried it out. And again, like LimeLife, that's why I say go for the samples, people. Go for the little small things that are trials. Like the lollipop, little lollipop, little. I think is what it was called. I said because it is small little trials that you can instead of paying. So enduring eyeliner, I think I said it was $28. Okay, for one eyeliner, it's $28. When you can get four samples for $38, four trial sizes, it's worth trying. I mean, why not, right? So, it's, like I said, I really like the eyeliner just because it is easy to fix when you make a mistake. And it really is waterproof and smudge proof, and it won't come off. Simple. So it's something like that I can stand behind. And it is what they advertise it to be. What they advertise is what the product actually does. And that's a company but I don't mind standing behind. And the fact that it's organic, it's chemical free, perfume free, a lot of it's vegan. Potato, potato. Hey. Yeah, I mean, it's good stuff. So, if you want help with anything, message me and I'll be glad to help you guys and or just have questions or want to talk, or if you want me to send you some of the skincare samples that I'm going to get in on this week. Like I said, hopefully they're supposed to be here Tuesday, they said. I'll send you some samples. Like I said, Bamboo Renew, Quench Cleanse, Skin Therapy, and pedicure cream. Oh, a lot of things go through my head sometimes. So just ask and I'll help. And like I said, if you just want to ask me questions about it, about Lyme life, I'll do my best to answer those questions for you. So, all right, that's it, guys. That's all I got. I'm done. I spent 46 minutes here just rambling, 47 minutes now rambling. And this is definitely not one of my best videos I've had, but hey, it is what it is. So maybe we'll make Friday night our live night of me sitting down just talking to you for a while. And during the week, it's hard for me to do live videos in the mornings because I'm trying to get ready for work and stuff, and I just don't have time to get everything set up and go and that kind of thing. So, and one of these days, maybe I'll buy a better phone and and it'll have better sound to it than what I have right now. So, all right, that's it. I am officially done. I've been telling you that for 30 minutes now. So, you guys have a great night. You got questions? Want to try anything? Just let me know. And I'll be around. So, hope you guys have a great weekend. And have fun. Be careful. Be safe. And be well. Bye, guys.